just flew in on his little G4 from Florida to Colorado Springs so he can go check out Dragon Man's museum. What'd you think, Ed?
Every time we check out that museum, there's more and more innovations, and it's the best World War II museum I have ever come across. Better than anyone can imagine. Wow!
Yeah, this is World War, not even a moth hole in it.
Wow.
Excellent shape.
Little guy.
Yeah, here's the leggings. See, that you put over your
boots.
Low quarter shoes. Yeah, we even got like the,
Holy shit.
Duffel bag. Very, very rare stuff. Unbelievable. All this stuff survived. And let's see what we got here. Okay, here's one of his tunics.
Corporal?
Yeah, corporal, two stripes.
You're pretty good at this shit, Will.
Yeah, look at this, his overcoat. This is very rare. Look how good shape it is. Yeah, so this is like 100 and, let's see, would be like 104 years old.
Must have been sitting in the closet.
More stuff here. Oh, look at this. His machete.
Holy shit.
Wow, I never even seen one like this. I seen pictures. Here, look, you open this. Here's the zipper. Even the zipper's in great shape.
Look at this.
Wow.
Like a sickle.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to get hit with that. And let's see what else we got here. Oh, look at this. Little booklets.
Oh, man.
Yeah, how to fight with your knife. Yeah, fighting booklet.
Wow.
How to sharpen it. World War One.
Oh my God, you gotta be careful.
Yeah, here it is. Yeah, look at that.
Unbelievable.
Hey, look, it shows how to fight with it.
Wow.
Hey, that's pretty rare. Let's see what else we got in here. We got more pants, we got a shirt. Hey, a little pouch.
This is better than Goodwill.
Oh, yep. This is his underwear. Oh, no, it's a pouch.
Good.
Yeah, there's a pouch. Here, it's got his name on it. His name was Robert. And some more leggings. These are very rare.
They look unused.
So,
they do, most of this stuff.
Really getting a lot of stuff out here. So anyway, this uniform here is super rare. I have three of them now. And let me show you a couple of pictures here. There we go. Now the 2nd Armored Division wore these on D-Day, June 6th, 1944. And they only lasted 90 days, 3 months. And then they made it, all the soldiers take everything off. The whole division. A division in the army is 15,000 soldiers.
Why? What'd they do?
What happened is, see, in 1944, see, that's what it says?
Yeah.
Everything I just told you is written right here. They mistaken the Americans wearing these uniforms for the Germans.
Oh.
Yeah, here, let me show you. In 1944, the Germans came out with a uniform that looked almost just like that. See? 1944.
Wow.
So how would you know if this guy's an American real fast or a German? You're not going to stop and ask him. So they were shooting their own men.
Wow.
So they discontinued the whole uniform. It actually looks like a Marine uniform, but the Marines didn't wear that, just the Army. So we're going to take them out now and put them in a museum. I'm making a whole display of the rarest World War II uniforms.
Well, that's World War One, though, right?
Right, but the World War Two uniforms. Right, you got to listen to what I'm saying.
I did.
Right, and if you have a question, raise your hand, or you could go sit in your car.
Otherwise, what were they wearing? Just they were just wearing green.
Just a regular green. Yep, the M43, jackets, the M43 fighting jackets. Yep, and the regular wool pants. Yeah, nothing special. Okay, you want to help me? You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Leslie, just tell people we'll be right back. This is super rare. We're real lucky to get this.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it says right on here. Here, the date is 1910. You can hardly see it. It's like worn out.
What are these?
Okay, we just got a question here. What was your name?
Neil.
Neil, just ask a question. And my job as a good teacher is to answer the question with the proper answer. Okay, these are really rare. Okay, yeah, let me show you how rare this is. Okay, this holds the kerosene that lights the headlights and the taillight on the 1917 World War I Dodge. Okay, so you take the cap off of here. Here, see, like that? Now this acts as a spigot. Here, look at that. You can even smell it. You smell the kerosene? Here, look at that. And now you could undo this a little bit so the air goes in there, and you pour that, you know, and fill up the headlight and the taillight. You know, because there was no battery or alternator back then. So these are really, really rare. I was real lucky to get these from another collector. I'm really getting some really rare stuff. Yeah, this is where the kerosene stuff goes. Yeah, these are kerosene headlights, taillights. See that? Spotlight. And this is what one of the first Dodge motors looked like. Yeah, it was only like 24 horsepower. See, no batteries back then. It had magnetos. And it's got primers on the top. I prime it, put the magneto switch on, 3 or 4 cranks, starts up every year. No fuel pumps either. Wow. See, the gas tanks had to be higher than a carburetor. And the stuff I don't use for a long time, see, I jack it up so it doesn't distort the wooden spokes of the tires.
Wow.
Yep. Those are the three types of guns, rifles they used during World War
II. Yeah, it's a Springfield, right?
Yeah, Springfield, one? Yep. Remington, Winchester. Eddie Stone, you ever hear of that? Eddie Stone.
Bottom looks like an M1 almost.
Yeah.
Without a first glance.
Wouldn't it be like the ultra cool thing to have him as your teacher in fucking, you know, history?
Yeah.
Fucking be unbelievable.
Okay, where's my helper?
What do you need help with?
See, and then the top goes on it, and the strap goes around it. Yeah, see that? And it goes in the back of the vehicle. Okay, so grab this guy.
All right.
I didn't name him yet. And I'll take a few things. How's that, huh? Yeah, this is going to be the rarest uniforms for World War II. Yeah, we even got the tent there. See, they made the same camouflage.
Every time I come to this place.
Yeah, I was real lucky to get all this stuff. Very, very rare.
Put this over there.
Yeah. Well, let's show them. I'll show you my Battle of the Bulge display we're working on. You put both lights on. There you go. We got some more medics. This. All medics. I didn't name them yet. That's my World War II landmine display. Okay, here. I'll show you my newest display we're working on.
Go ahead. That's a real tank.
It's M60?
No,
that's
no.
That's a T-54 Russian tank.
Oh, crap.
And it runs.
Yeah. Wow. It looks a lot like an M60.
What do you think? Mike, you see this yet?
Yeah.
Huh?
Wow. It's growing. Oh, everything grows.
What do you think, huh?
Wow. Amazing.
Yeah, it's going to go over there, right?
I got it.
Okay. We still got a lot of work to do. We just filled up, 53 sandbags yesterday?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right here or further back?
Further back, and then you can put the top on. And I got to arm all these guys. They need ammo belts. They need suspenders. We got to get a couple of medics are going to be in here. I got all different lights we're going to put in here. It's going to be like a war going on with sound effects.
Oh.
And it's going to go all the way down to the end. That's the type of CCKW, deuce and a half, they use during World War II.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah, and I got pictures here. See, Battle of the Bulls? See that? December 16th to January 25th. And let's see, December 22nd, who came and saved the 101st Airborne?
Patton.
General Patton with three divisions, right?
How many is in a division?
15,000 soldiers. Wow. So 45,000 soldiers he showed up with. The 3rd and 4th Armored Division and the 28th Infantry.
Wow.
Right. But there was over 200,000 Germans fighting the Americans. And Battle of the Bulge lasted, it stretched over 65 miles, like from here to Denver. But the main town was called Bastogne. And that's where...
Were the Russians involved?
No. They were still... They didn't come over the border yet. But that was Hitler's last big,
stand.
To stop the Allies from the advance. Mm-hmm. So people are really going to learn a lot when they come this year to see my museum. And see the way I put the camouflage up there on the ceiling? So I got more coming to do all this.
Oh.
Yeah. And colored lights, and it's going to really look good.
Yeah. Everything you do is so real.
Yep, realistic, yep.
No, real too. More than realistic.
Yeah, this is my plan, is to make this one of the best privately owned museums in the United States. Who's going to beat this?
I don't think there's
Right.
I think you passed the Smithsonian for sure.
Yep, and what makes my museum special, see the machine guns? They work. The government would never allow anything like that. All these weapons are real. The mannequins have real firearms, real bullets, right? And you ever see that movie, Night at the Museum? That's why we don't work in here after 12 o'clock. It's very dangerous. Anything can happen. Okay, guys, hope you liked the fast video. You guys stay tuned. The museum opens April 3rd on a Sunday for the whole season. And if you want to see one of the best museums in the country, you come see the Dragon Man. Any questions, give me a call, 719-683-2200. Just remember, you snooze, you lose. Hope you liked the little tour.
It was awesome.
And,
thanks.
Keeps getting better and better. More better.
Hopefully we'll make more way back when it's fully open.
Yeah. Yeah, this goes all the way down the aisle here. See, I cover everything up for the winter.
Yeah.
Oh, in case the roof leaks a little bit, you know.
Wow.
That's a World War I nurse.
Is that an anti-aircraft spotlight?
Yeah, got two of them. Yeah, they put out a billion candlelight. And a generator I have for it.
Look at that one.
And a gun to match.
What's that?
Elvis.
That's right.